You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
So next, let's talk about the viewer and some of the icons up here. So I'm going to select my source in the trees window here, and you can see that this is what is listed when I'm looking at this pull down here. And this is what nodes you are selected on. And then each node has different views. So of course the source just has the output node, but if I'm on the Roto node, you can see that I have several choices for the viewer. And then we have the pull down here for how the viewer updates. So mine is always set to drag, which is immediate, and then it goes all the way to manual, which is no updating. And then we have the proxy pull down. We're set to 1:1 here, but if you have a large number of frames or if your file size is very large, then you want to work at a different proxy size. But if you're in Paint, you always want to make sure that you are 1:1. Next up here is the input color space and the view transform. And if you have a LUT, you can have that loaded in. And we have a couple sliders here, which are non-destructive to edit your viewer. So for example, if I just slide this, you can see I can change the gain and the gamma. If you want to do this with very small increments, then you can hold down the control command key. And if you slide, then it goes in much smaller increments. And then to reset, you just click the button here to the right, and that will reset you back to the defaults. And one thing to note here is that Silhouette will interpret your footage to what it thinks it is when you create your session after you're clicked on your footage. As we move across the top of the viewer, you can see there's a number of icons up here. And if I mouse over them or put my Wacom pen over them, you can see the tooltips. So that's a snapshot. That's really good for painting and comping. And then here is the display options. If I click on this, it expands or collapses the icons on the top of the viewer. So I always leave this on. And then here is the ROI icon. So that's a region of interest. If I click this, and maybe I'll just zoom out a little bit, you can see I have a border around my image. If I had a really long frame range or my file size is very large and I want to conserve memory, I can actually just pull in on my borders here, and now I have a smaller region of interest to work on. And that's really, really handy. And if you don't want to see these lines around your image, you can just click that and you have your image that is just in the viewer itself. So you can also have these dotted lines disappear with a preference that's in the viewer. And I'll show you that right now. To bring up the preferences, there's a hotkey, command comma, and I'll bring that up and let's find that. So we're in the viewer and display ROI outline. I'm just going to disable that. If I click OK, then I go back and now I can just see that I have no dotted line around my image. Another great thing about the ROI, let's just enable the border once more, is that it's keyframeable. For example, if I wanted to keyframe this, I can just go ahead and keyframe. So you see the little watch icon here. I keyframe it there. And if I wanted to, if I say my object that I'm rotoing is moving all around the canvas or the shot, I can just make a smaller ROI there. And then you can see if I scrub through that my ROI is actually animating. So that's a very handy tool. Okay, so let's reset this and move on. We'll just click the reset button and we are back to where we started, and we will just disable the ROI icon. And then I'm going to press F and it's going to frame my image into the viewer. Next up, we have the surface tool, show surface, which we won't be using for now in Roto. And then we have the magnifier tool. If I enable that, you can see that I have a square box down in the lower right hand corner of my viewer, and that it is sort of zoomed in where my cursor is. But I usually leave that disabled. That's a personal preference. Next is the icon for the format mask. And so what's nice about this is if you have one loaded in, you can see your crop. And then we have this icon here, which is a stabilized icon. And we will use this tool a lot where we can select a layer from this icon, the pull down after we make some layers, and view our roto and our tracking in a stabilized view. Next is the rotate canvas, where we can actually rotate. If I click this and I want to rotate this, well, you have to use the hand to actually, and you can roto in a view that is not, you know, is that an angled view. So that's really cool. It's a little bit memory intensive, but it's a really neat feature. So then I'm just going to deselect that and turn that off, and it resets. And going down the line, we have the roto overlay, or actually the show tool overlay, and that is toggled on and off with zero. So if I press zero on my keyboard, if I have any overlays or my roto shapes visible, it will turn them off. And that's a great tool that I use all the time. And this little icon here is for notes, looks like a little notepad. So if I click on that, you can see here, if I had any notes, then they would appear in little boxes on the right here. And we'll explore that later. And we'll just disable that for now. And then here you can see I have the preview pull down. And here you can look at your images with all of these different options. And then last but not least, we have the RGBA channel selector. So right now we're in RGBA. If I want to look at the red channel, I can just click on the little box here, or the green or the blue. You can see that when I'm selected on a channel or in a channel view, that the white box is a white box around whatever channel is that I'm selected on. And then back to RGBA. Or you can use the hotkeys, which are Alt R, Alt G, Alt B, Alt A, and then back to RGBA. To the right of that, we have the alpha overlay opacity. Once we start making some shapes, we can see that as 100%, but we can also change that down to a lower opacity. And then we have the aspect ratio correction. And then we have our zoom level in the viewer. You can see I'm at 30%, but you can use the pull down here. So go to 100%. And if I press F again, I can just frame to fit. Okay, so moving around the interface, you can see that we have the timeline window at the bottom here, and that will be filled with more roto shapes and keyframes. And if I click on this tab next to it, this is the window that has all the silhouette nodes. And then if I click on a node, you can see that this node, the roto node, has an object list window associated with that. And then inside the roto node itself, there's a couple tabs different here. Down here, node and object, presets and notes. And there are different tabs inside of the node tab itself. So these will make more sense as we move along. We'll switch back to the timeline window here.